little over 150 years ago, on May 11, 1869, the first year of the Meiji era, Hijikata Toshirō, charismatic vice commander of the storied Shinsengumi, Japan's last samurai, met his end in battle defending the group's final stronghold on Japan. Hijikata Toshirō, vice commander of the infamous Shinsengumi, was born in Hino, in modern-day Tokyo on May 31, 1835, and was raised by his older brother and his wife, as Hijikata's father, a wealthy farmer, died just before his sixth child. Hijikata Toshirō was a mischievous child. He would climb up the roof of the temple and pick eggs from birds' nests and throw them at people on the street. But he had a sense of humanity and was kind to the people around him, that he carried on. Self-taught in swordsmanship, Hijikata Toshirō later entered training in the Tennin Rishin Ryu School's dojo in Hino, and through this came into contact with Kondo Asami. While the whereabouts of Hijikata's remains are unconfirmed, his sword did find its way back from the battlefield in the city of Hakodate, to the warrior's birthplace, the city of Hino in western Tokyo. Today the sword of Hijikata is revered enough that an annual airing at a museum in town attracts fans of Hijikata from around Japan and beyond. Hijikata and the Shinsengumi, literally newly selected corps, devoted their lives to defending a Tokugawa shogunate in the final throes of defeat to Meiji restoration reformers. The Shinsengumi reached the peak of its influence during a bloody period protecting the interests of the Tokugawa Bakufu on the streets of Kyoto. Hijikata has emerged as something of a hero from this turbulent period that ultimately ended in defeat for the Shinsengumi and the end of over two centuries of Tokugawa rule in Japan. The Hijikata Toshirō Museum opened in 1994 in response to the demands of Hijikata fans who came to Hino to learn more about their hero from the novels, manga, and video games. Among the museum's collection is a wooden practice sword used by Hijikata. The set of armor that the Shinsengumi vice commander was wearing during the Akidaya incident. The location of the home, in a quiet suburb in the city's east, formerly known as Ishida Village, is as much removed from the frantic pace of central Tokyo. To mark the 150th anniversary of Hijikata's passing, in the weekend in mid-May, a festival is held at the city's streets, shrines, and temples fill with Shinsengumi enthusiasts and demonstrations of Tennin Rishin Ryu samurai sword art. Two photographs of Hijikata are in existence. He is seated straight with a clean chiseled face and western uniform looks considerably more martial and handsome. As for a Japanese guy, he was quite dull. For the most part, Hijikata was, as said before, an efficient person, due to his calm and cautionary nature. A Frenchman, Jules Brunet, regarded him as a true warrior and estimated that Hijikata could have been a general if placed in Europe. The battle at Toba Fushimi was what changed Hijikata's outlook on war. He cut off his long hair and was very sad on hearing the death of Isami Kondo, the commander of Shinsengumi. Hijikata's troops were attacked by the Meiji forces. A bullet from a sniper, yes there are snipers at the time, pierced his abdomen and destroyed his lower back and spine, killing him on horseback. Thus Hijikata met his death, and that was the end of the last samurais of Japan.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video, then please do not forget to like it, subscribe it, and of course comment on it, and let me know if there is more to it. Thank you so much. See you next time.